name's Colin Murphy. I'm a Senior Product Marketing Manager at Microsoft, and I'm here today joined by Anna Thomas, a Data and Applied Scientist in our Data Division. So welcome, Anna.
Thanks, Colin. Excited to be here.
And today we're going to talk about link servers in Azure SQL Database. So Anna, can you explain what is link servers and how it's used?
Yeah, sure. So link servers in Azure SQL Database Managed Instance allow you to do things like access data from outside of Azure SQL Database Managed Instance. And you might want to do this to do distributed queries, updates, commands across, you know, your whole enterprise or your whole data estate. And you're also able to address diverse data sources in a similar fashion. And so it's really interesting. It's, you know, almost exactly the same as in SQL Server. The only difference is that we're still working on building out functionality to other providers apart from SQL Server and Azure SQL Database.
Okay, cool. So can you give me an example of some of the other providers that SQL Server supports on-prem with Link Server?
Yeah, so on-prem, I believe you can connect to things like Oracle or DB2 or other places that your data is located.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, but what's needed to connect to this is an OLDB provider and an OLDB data source. So we're just going to get into how you might set up that linked server. And I know there's a lot of comments here, but we'll just take it line by line. So basically what we're going to do is use this SP add linked server. And in doing that, we specify what we want to call our linked server, as well as the provider and the data source. And once we've got that input, we'll go ahead and add the linked server login using our username and password.
Great. And then I just noticed there, so you're connecting to the IP address. So this would be through like a VPN or express route. So you're obviously not connecting directly to it. You're going through a VPN, so effectively it's the same network. You're just your own private cloud using part of it as on-prem.
Right. Yeah. Exactly. And I should note that this instance that we're connecting to is actually a instance of SQL Server 2019 running on Linux.
Okay. Cool.
So once we have that created, we can optionally set a bunch of different options. And you can see we'll use SP server option to denote that in each case. And then you just specify the server and the name of the option and the value. So some of the options that you can do are enabling or disabling link server for distributed query access. You can enable RPC from and to the server. And you can also specify the timeout value for connecting or querying. And you can see here I'm using 0, which is just the default. A few other options that you can set here, but let's just go ahead and create that linked server. And so you can see it creates pretty quickly. We can go ahead and refresh this and take a look and see if we have it. And sure enough, we've got our SQL Server 2019 linked server appearing here now. Now what this enables us to do is something actually quite interesting, is to do something like a cross database join between Azure SQL Database Managed Instance and SQL Server 2019. So here you can see I'm joining name from both instances and the last modified date from each MI and SQL Server. And so I'm basically able to do a join across both and get side by side the values for MI as well as the values for SQL Server. So that's pretty cool. And finally, I can check the updatability of the linked server. And I just wanted to call this out because I find it quite interesting. But this allows me to see if it's a read-only or a read-write or the type of access I have to a linked server. And in this case, you see that I have read-write access to that SQL Server 2019 instance.
Oh, that's really cool. So so with the linked server and doing this cross database join, I can actually leverage all the investments I've made in SQL Server on-prem. It's the same skill set. And now I can actually start using the cloud with Azure SQL Database Managed Instance. And nothing's changed, it's just the same.
Yeah, exactly. And there's one other cool thing too that you can do that's because of the way Managed Instance is set up. I can actually leverage the secondary that we have and use it as a read-only source. And so I can use this to offload heavy workloads that are read-based.
Oh, that's really great. Thank you, Anna. So that's really useful information. I didn't know what Link Server was before, so thank you again. So everyone, thank you for watching in, and give us a like if you like this, and subscribe. And then we'll give you more information on where to get info on Link Server. So thank you very much.
Thanks.